Morning, everybody. Morning,
Good morning,
everybody.
sir. Good
Yeah.
morning. Good morning, sir.
Morning. Haji. What doubts do you have? I believe there are some doubts in the class. So what are the doubts? You told Captain Rajat that you wanted some more classes from me on ROR. So what are the doubts regarding that? I wanted to ask that. Can somebody in the class tell me what are the doubts? Please tell me what are the doubts, because I've come specially only for taking those doubts.
सर आज आपने कहा था केस स्टडी डिस्कस करेंगे एक बार वाली कोरिया वाली सर सैमसंग वाली आपने कहा था केस स्टडी डिस्कस करूंगा तुम्हारे साथ
अच्छा ओके ऑल राइट सो द केस स्टडी ओके हैज एनीबडी मैनेज्ड टू सी एंड रीड अबाउट हाई बाय स्पिरिट किसने पढ़ा है हाई स्पिरिट के बारे में कि नहीं राजवीर आप अपना जरा माइक म्यूट कर लीजिए आपका कंटिन्यूअसली ऑन हो रहा है ओके सो देयर वाज दिस केस अबाउट हाई बाय स्पिरिट And in that, there is this vessel, High by Spirit, at anchor. She is a VLCC, fully loaded. She is off the Korean coast. And here is a Samsung barge. Which is a tug and a huge tow. The tow was huge. This was a Samsung barge. And the distance off is roughly 4 miles. Wind force is 8/9. So pretty strong winds blowing, very rough weather. And in this kind of a weather, the Samsung barge, ये यहाँ से clear करके चला गया है इसके बाव से आगे से. And now this tow line parts, ये snap करती है यहाँ से. So this barge now, which was somewhere over here, at the time of snapping, she now becomes adrift. And now, as luck would have, she keeps drifting like this, like this, like this, like this, and finally bangs over here. Yahan pe takkar marta hai. And During this process of banging, यहाँ से crude oil leak करता है and it goes and it damages the shoreline and all the beaches over there and the fishermen lose their livelihood. So the South Korean government promptly arrests Captain Jaspreet Chawla, Indian master. And the chief officer. And the electrical officer. And puts them behind bars. And I think the third officer also. And so therefore they were put behind bars. And then they were released after about 1 year. The question which comes across is that how is this whistle to be blamed? Well, let's firstly say if you were on the duty officer of this anchored vessel, what all would you have done, supposing a barge was approaching you from this instance onwards? Let us say this is 0700 hours in the morning, and the time this strikes over here is 720 hours this collision occurred. So I want to know, what action would you take on this anchored vessel over here chronologically? So let us start one by one. If somebody can tell me point number one, what would you like to do?
Sir, emergency letting go the anchor and then underway ho jayenge, sir.
Emergency letting go anchor? You're already anchored, bhai. Ab kya let go karoge? Aur kitna karna hai tumne let go?
Bitter end khul ke pura jaane denge anchor ko aur jaldi se underway ho jayenge. Kyunki agar heave up karenge to time lagega.
This is going to be your first action. सबसे
पहले तो port state control को करेंगे contact.
सर master को.
Sorry sir.
Call master सर पहला action तो.
सबसे पहले तो call.
Call master sir.
Okay, call master. हाँ जी. Any other action other than that? उसके बाद.
सर उसके बाद engine prepare करेंगे. Engine room में बोल देंगे. Emergency alarm कर देंगे सर.
Thank God. Okay. So emergency alarm should be the first action. Emergency alarm. So jab main emergency alarm karunga, to mujhe call master bhi karne ki zarurat nahi hai kyunki sab log jaag jayenge. So emergency alarm mein engine room bhi jaag gaya, master bhi jaag gaya, sab log jaag gaye. Next. What else would you like to do?
Sir, engine room ko call karke inform karenge main engine ready karne ko.
Okay. Main engine to be made ready. Okay. Engine room informed. Next. हाँ जी.
नेक्स्ट. सर VHF से पोर्ट पे इन्फॉर्म करेंगे सर.
इन्फॉर्म पोर्ट कंट्रोल.
यस सर.
इन्फॉर्म पोर्ट कंट्रोल. आर यू एबल टू सी पॉइंट नंबर फोर और शिल?
यस सर.
बहुत लाइट दिख रहा
है. हाँ
लाइट दिख रहा है सर. बहुत बहुत लाइट.
बहुत लाइट है. ओके ओके. इन्फॉर्म पोर्ट कंट्रोल. एनीथिंग एल्स यू लाइक टू डू
सर? वो बार्ज को भी वेचे में बुलाएंगे
सर. कॉल फॉर एंकर स्टेशन.
करेक्ट. All anchor stations. What else?
So portable fenders ready on port side.
Correct. Absolutely right. Portable fenders on port side to be standby. If I have Yokohama fenders, then have them also. Yokohama fenders, you know what they are?
Yes, sir, automatic fender.
So those are the Yokohama fenders. So have them also rigged up. What else? What else?
सर अगर कोलिजन कंफर्म्ड है कि अब होना ही होना है तो फिर वी विल ट्राई टू अलाइन द शिप इन सच ए वे दैट डैमेज इज मिनिमम.
वो बाद में आएगा, अभी पहले और क्या क्या चीजें हमने मिस की हैं अभी तक, पहले वो सोचो क्या क्या मिस और कर हो सकता है. इनफॉर्म पोर्ट कंट्रोल कर दिया, कॉल एंकर स्टेशंस कर दिया, पोर्ट पोर्टेबल फेंडर्स लगा दिए, और क्या कर सकता हूँ मैं.
मिनिमम ऑयल ग्रेसली ट्रांसफर कर सकते हो या लिस्ट कर दे थोड़ा सा जाके.
वो अभी अभी वो सब कुछ नहीं है अभी, पहले तो अभी तो मुझे कोलिजन एंटी कोलिजन की बातें करो पहले, पोस्ट कोलिजन की बातें बाद में करूंगा, पहले एंटी कोलिजन की बातें हो रही हैं अभी. अभी पहले सबसे पहले तो मुझे ये डिसाइड करना है एट दिस स्टेज व्हाट शुड आई डू. सपोजिंग आई हैव गॉट वीएलसीसी नॉर्मल सर्कमस्टेंस, इट वुड बी 8 ऑन डेक. सपोजिंग normal circumstance, 8 on deck, 9 on deck. So supposing I am 8 on deck or 9 on deck, ab mujhe ye decide karna hai ki should I pay out more or should I start picking up. I have to think of all that. So which is a more better option? Should I start picking it up? Should I pay out more? That I have to think. Both the actions are okay. Ultimately, if I pay out more, I am increasing the distance. If I pick up the cable, then I can get away very jaldi if I have to. Both the options are existing. In this case, particular scenario, which one would you prefer? Picking up or paying out more?
Paying out more.
So in this particular scenario where I have got 20 minutes of TCPA, it would be a good idea to start picking up. The anchor cable. That means shorten the cable which is down. So you start picking up the anchor cable. Normal anchor, agar aap uthate ho full speed pe, how much time does it take on full speed to pick up your anchor? Any ideas?
So for one shackle it takes about 3 minutes.
So say we are talking about 8 shackles on your last ship. Any ideas?
30 minutes.
20 minutes to pick up.
Yeah, approx 20 minutes like that. So that means जो मेरे पास 20 मिनट ये थे, उस 20 मिनट में मैं अपना एंकर को पूरा उठा सकता हूँ. That is the reason why we are picking up on full speed. You start shortening the cable. And if by chance, in 20 minutes, this barge has come over here at this situation, and you are one on deck, supposing, at that point in time, what can you do at that stage? Supposing the vessel barge was at this position, and you—that means one. We are now talking about 50 meters away. 50 meter ki duri pe hai.
What's the word, do you think?
Sir, we will give a little. Master will give an astern kick. Will move the rudder port to take on the head.
Correct. So you can give full astern even with one down in water with your ankle down. You can still dredge the cable Get what I'm trying to say? You can drag the anchor. You can dredge. It is called dredging the anchor. Has anybody seen it being done up till now? Dredging the anchor?
Yes, sir.
You've seen it?
Yes, sir. While birthing, I have seen it.
Yeah, while birthing. Perfectly right. Absolutely right. While birthing, we do that. We dredge the anchor. हम जब जेटी के आ रहे होते हैं सपोजिंग पोर्ट साइड अलॉन्ग साइड जाना है मुझे तो आई एम मे बी हाफ अ माइल ऑफ द जेटी आई ड्रॉप माय एंकर एंड नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ टग्स और पावर और अदरवाइज आई कीप ड्रेजिंग द एंकर एंड आई कीप मूविंग सो व्हाट इज दिस इट्स अ कंट्रोल्ड स्पीड कंट्रोल्ड रेट ऑफ अप्रोच ताकि मैं जाके जेटी में बैंक नहीं करूँगा इज इट ओके So, even if I start picking up the anchor, shorten the cable, full speed, be prepared. For dredging the anchor. That means you can go, if need be, full astern on main engine. With one on deck, one shackle on deck. Can do that. What else would you do? Five short and rapid blasts to attract attention. Five short and rapid blasts to attract the attention. Keep using Aldis lamp. अभी तक किसी ने इसको अलार्म को साउंड ही उसके लिए किया ही नहीं था अभी तक. Aldis lamp, search light to attract attention. Please do all that. Is that okay? What else can you do? So basically, maneuver the vessel. Out of the path of the barge. And one of the things not expected out of you guys, but expected from a master's level is predict the drift direction of the barge. You by now in 20 minutes you should have calculated kis direction mein barge drift kar rahi hai. Be aware of the wind direction. Wind direction kidhar ja rahe wali hai, kaise ja rahi hai, taki mujhe pata chale, taki main uske path se bahar niklu. Agar supposing barge meri aise ja rahi hai is direction mein. So where should my direction be? I should head up back like this and then get out like this. This should be my way to get out. Of course, by going astern. Not going ahead for sure. Because I have to, my aim should be to increase my TCPA at all times. My TCPA should increase. That should be my aim. So, अगर मुझे इसका पाथ पता है तो मैं इसके पाथ से बाहर निकल के आई शुड कीप गो परपेंडिकुलर टू इट द पाथ ऑफ इट
सर ये तो डायरेक्ट प्रेडिक्ट द ड्रिफ्ट की डायरेक्शन ही तो फिर सबसे पहले करेंगे ना मास्टर आके
करेक्ट That's right. That's why it's very important at this point of time for the mate actually to be on the bridge. The second mate should have been sent again. The mate should be on the bridge to assist the master. Because jump crisis hota hai, in moments of crisis, the bridge should be adequately manned. Master to hota hi hai bridge pe, but master ke saath mate hona chahiye. Aur second mate aage hona chahiye. Na ki, what do we do most commonly? Hum mate ko aage bhej dete hain, normal case. So the bridge is what? Master and the third mate. And God help if the third mate is freshly made, promoted, or just a new one. Then he doesn't have any experience. Then he's just a glorified cadet. So he's not able to contribute to the bridge team in moments of crisis. So one of the roles of you all as an important member of the bridge team is to suggest alternative methods or remedies to the master. I know it's a very difficult thing to do for you, but as a prudent third mate, jab crisis ho, us waqt master is in deep shit. He's under a lot of stress. You have to contribute to the master by giving him suggestions, because his mind is now only focused on the crisis and nothing else. He's not thinking anything else. So you are there on the bridge. You have to contribute to his awareness to make master aware of the changing scenario around. Master ko aap sara jo scenario change hota ja raha hai uske bare mein aap bataoge, so that he is then able to function better. You have to make him aware. And keep SOPE equipment standby. All your SOPE equipment should be standby.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Hanji.
Sir, if in that case there was a wind force of 8 or 9, should the vessel still be at anchor?
Of course. Vessel should be at anchor only, obviously. Vessel kahan jayega? Agar anchor vessel to anchor pe rehte hai na? When the wind force increases, vessel is still at anchor. You can't go anywhere. No? Once you've dropped anchor, kahan jaoge aap? Unless until there is a cyclone which is coming, then the port tells you, please get out, bahar raho, go out to sea. Otherwise, you are at anchor only, na? So kahan jaoge?
Sir, I don't remember the exact value of the wind speed, but my company said that if wind speed was so and so, you pick up anchor.
Possible. Aapki policy bhi ho sakta hai, this thing. But here, it is not necessary. Wind force is, see, I have written 8 or 9. It could have been 7 or 8. Could have been 6 or 7. That's not the point. The point what I'm trying to make here is, it was wind force, heavy wind force.
Okay, sir. Okay.
The quantum is immaterial.
राइट सर,
वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग हियर कि 8 नहीं 8.5 था, नहीं 9 था, नहीं 7 था, हम उस पे डिबेट थोड़ी कर रहे हैं, हम तो एक्शन की बातें कर रहे हैं। एंड विंड फोर्स अगर होता है तो हम ड्रॉप एंकर करते हैं, इट्स अ वेरी स्टैंडर्ड थिंग। उल्टा जब विंड फोर्स और इंक्रीज कर जाता है तो हम थोड़ा और पे करते हैं, डोंट वी डू दैट सो एज टू क्रिएट अ कैटेनरी। द केबल शुड बी लाइंग अलोंग द सी बेड एंड देन कमिंग अप फॉर्मिंग अ कैटेनरी। So, the SOPA equipment should be standby. Now, in this particular scenario, what happened was a lot of things were not done. What was done was VHF pe, Samsung Baj on my port bow, Samsung Baj on my port bow, please keep clear of me, please keep clear of me. Bolte rahe, 20 minute guzar gaye. Yehi chalta raha bridge pe. अब वो बार्ज तो ऑलरेडी खुद पैनिक में है, वो क्या करेगा? आपके वीएचएफ बोलने से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला, यू आर वेस्टिंग योर टाइम। ये हुआ, टाइम वेस्ट हुआ सारा। वो जो टग था इन द मीन टाइम, उसने कोशिश करी टू कम बिटवीन द शिप एंड द बार्ज, बट ये बार जितनी बड़ी थी और तब तक विंडेज जब एक बार शुरू हो जाता है और वो ड्रिफ्ट शुरू हो जाती है, उसके बाद उसको रोकना बहुत मुश्किल होता है, तो वो टग जो था वो रोक ही नहीं पाया, वो अंडर पावर्ड था टग, तो वो उसको रोक ही नहीं पाया, वो टग को लेके भी ड्रिफ्ट करता रहा। उसका तब तक मोमेंटम इतना बन चुका था, उसकी ड्रिफ्ट स्पीड ऑलमोस्ट 4 नॉट्स की हो चुकी थी बार्ज की, अब वो 4 नॉट की स्पीड पे ड्रिफ्ट कर रहा था पूरा। It was like he was making way.
लेकिन सर अगर टग बीच में होगी तो शिप पे इम्पैक्ट थोड़ा सा कम आएगा ना, या ऐसा कुछ होगा?
हाँ, but you, ये I am now talking about when she was about 2 miles away.
Yes sir.
So उसके बाद में जब टग उसको कंट्रोल नहीं कर पाया तो टग उसको छोड़ गया, वहां से निकल के भाग गया, तो टग ran away because he could now see danger. So he abandoned the tow. Ab the barge was on its own. Aur ye lage hue hain abhi bhi VHF pe, Samsung barge bulaye ja rahe hain. And ultimately usne jab aake tha mara port side pe VLCC ko at that point in time, fir puncture hua. Ab tel leak karne lag gaya. अब मास्टर ने कार्गो ऑपरेशन शुरू किए ब्रिज पे, तो उसने सबसे पहले तो एक लिस्ट क्रिएट करी स्टारबोर्ड साइड में, ताकि ये जो गैश था ये जितना भी पानी के ऊपर आ सके, तो उसकी ये इंटेंशन थी, तो उसने ये किया क्रिएट स्टारबोर्ड लिस्ट करी क्रिएट। अब उसके चीज में दिमाग में दूसरी चीज आई कि टक्कर हुई है, क्रूड ऑयल है अंदर में, तो फायर हैजर्ड भी हो सकता है, तो उसने इस टैंक में आईजी इंजेक्ट करी, आईजी प्रेशर, ताकि इनर्ट कंडीशन मेंटेन हो, ताकि फायर ना हो। तो उससे क्या हुआ कि जब आईजी इंजेक्ट करी तो आईजी क्रिएटेड प्रेशर ऑन द ऑयल एंड सो इंक्रीज द रेट ऑफ आउटफ्लो लीकिंग फ्रॉम द वेसल, thereby causing मोर पोल्यूशन। ये दो थे जो कि साउथ कोरियन लॉयर्स ने जब मास्टर एंड मेट को अरेस्ट किया तो ये कॉजेज डाले कि नंबर वन VHF पे बोलते रहे टाइम स्पेंड कर रहे हैं, वेस्टिंग टाइम. और दूसरा इनर्ट गैस आईजी इंजेक्ट करी विद द एम ऑफ नॉट हैविंग फायर, बट दैट इन टर्न इंक्रीज द पोल्यूशन एंड देयरफॉर एनहांस पोल्यूशन. ये दो थे जो कि चार्जेस उस पर फ्रेम हुए जिसके बेसिस पे इनको अरेस्ट किया गया. उसके बाद वो केस लंबा चला, फाइट बड़ी लंबी हुई, एंड इवेंचुअली ऑफ कोर्स आफ्टर वन ईयर दे वर रिलीज्ड अंडर ट्रेमेंडस प्रेशर, बट इट वाज अ बिग बिग केस एट दैट पॉइंट इन टाइम एंड लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स टू लर्न फ्रॉम इट. दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई आई मेड यू राइट सो मेनी पॉइंट्स सो दैट नाउ दिस कैन बी पिक्ड अप बाय यू in any case of a, let's say, a vessel at anchor collision. So you can pick it up. Or in any other normal case also, any other contingency. You have to remember, it is very important to cover up all the points. And then some sequence. Sequence is very important. Hoti hai. Haan ji, any other doubt in this? Any other doubt?
सर जैसे कि मतलब ये नॉर्मल दूसरा डाउट है सर कि अभी ऐसे किसी से केस के अंदर में एक्शन नहीं लिया और सिर्फ जैसे वीएचएफ पे बोलते रहे तो किस तो ये तो मतलब क्योंकि
नहीं एक्शन लिया और एक चीजें करी हैं उन्होंने. ऐसा नहीं है कि कुछ कोई खाली बस वीएचएफ पे बोलते रहे, मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा हूं.
ओके
बहुत एक्शन लिए उन्होंने. दे टुक लॉट ऑफ एक्शंस. ओके द मास्टर वाज कॉम्प्लीमेंटेड. एक्चुअली मैंने खाली आपको दो पॉइंट बताए हैं जिस पॉइंट पे वो उसको अरेस्ट किया, बट उन्होंने मास्टर ने बहुत कुछ किया. ओके देयर वर स्टैंड बाय बोट स्टेशंस वर कॉल्ड, अबैंडन शिप वाज रेडी, पीपल वर रेडी ऑन द नियर द लाइफ बोट स्टेशंस, नॉट अ सिंगल लाइफ वाज लॉस्ट. तो बहुत कुछ पॉजिटिव चीजें थी इसमें. तो मास्टर डिड लॉट ऑफ राइट थिंग्स. तो पॉइंट्स जहाँ पे मैं वो बहुत खाली बता रहा हूँ जो कि जब जिसमें कि उनको चार्ज किया गया, बस इतना बोल रहा हूँ मैं.
सर एक बार स्क्रीन भी दिखा देना प्लीज बोर्ड.
Sir, I have a doubt from Rule 14, sir.
Yes, please, go ahead.
Sir, it states that reciprocal or nearly reciprocal courses. So right. Here, reciprocal means 180 or 360 degree. But right. What does nearly reciprocal mean in terms of bearing?
Okay. So you will have to go into Annex 1. In Annex 1, just open up the sectors of the light. So read Annex 1, sectors of the light.
So horizontal sectors.
Horizontal, correct. So there is something called as horizontal. Hanji.
So A point number one, in the forward direction, side light as fitted on the vessel shall show the minimum required intensities. The intensities must decrease to reach practical cutoff between 1 to 3 degrees outside the prescribed sectors.
Okay. अच्छा आगे.
Point number two, for stern lights and masthead light and at 22.5 degrees above the beam for side lights, the minimum required intensities shall be maintained over the arc of horizon up to 5 degrees within the limit of the sectors prescribed in Rule 21. From 5 degrees within the prescribed sector, the intensity may decrease by 50% up to the prescribed limits. It shall decrease steadily to reach practical cutoff at not more than 5 degrees outside the prescribed sectors.
So, plus 5 degrees outside the sector.
Okay.
So now, so your limits are for masthead lights plus 5 degrees outside the prescribed sector. That is your limit. So if I am heading 000 and there's this vessel, she's heading 180, then and she's bearing 000. At this point of time, right? And there is another vessel who is also heading 180. She is now bearing 005. And there is another vessel. She is bearing 355. All these three vessels will become nearly reciprocal. Of course, this one will be reciprocal. These two will be nearly reciprocal. That is the meaning of it.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. And supposing there is another vessel over here. She is bearing 006. Then this is not nearly reciprocal. Similarly, there is another vessel here. 354. Then this is not, but these are. That's the meaning. Theek hai, is this understood?
No, yes, sir. Somebody.
So, Hanji, any other doubt? Or koi doubt? Okay. I am done with the rules which are required for the written exams. These are the rules which we have done in the class. Written paper mein, these are the ones. Then the same rules will continue in for different situations, and then that will come for the oral part of it. Okay. For the written, these are good enough, whatever we have done in class so far. Jitne bhi humne kiye, these are the ones which come. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
In case you still have something. Hanji?
Board, sir, ek bari. Thank you, sir.
Theek hai. Chalo. All the best, and you can contact Captain Rajat Jain for making your file in case you guys have still not made your file. Please start making your file. You can contact Captain Rajat Jain and he'll guide you with regards to making the file. Okay?
Sir, can I take 1 minute, sir, please? Sir, ye, yeah. Sir.
Hanji, boliye.
Sir, ye. 355 वाला सर आप बोल रहे नियरली रेसिप्रोकल है और ये 354 वाला आप मना करें सर ऐसा क्यों सर फिर से बता देंगे सर
अभी तो मैंने आपको सारे बताया वो उसमें जो हॉरिजॉन्टल सेक्टर ऑफ लाइट्स है उसमें प्लस 5 डिग्रीज आउटसाइड द लिमिट्स जो है उसकी कट आउट हो जाती है जो मास्टहेड लाइट है वो कट आउट कर जाएगी ना अपनी लिमिट के बाहर में वो नजर नहीं
yes, आएगी
तो वो जब लाइट ही नहीं नजर आएगी तो फिर वो कैसे मैं उसको हेड ऑन बोलूंगा सो 354 में अगर कोई बेरिंग में जहाज होगा मेरे जो कि 180 आ रहा है तो मुझे उसकी नहीं नजर आएगी, बट 355 में नजर आएगी।
ओके सर,
ठीक है, ऑल राइट, सो सी यू देन, बाय, ऑल द बेस्ट,
थैंक यू सर, बाय बाय,
बाय बाय। Please finish off all your file work within this.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Fine.
Okay, bye. Oh. All the best.
Good afternoon.